Hello, hello, I'm back. Welcome to my new video series about building web application. It will focus more on tools to build your applications and how to use them rather than writing the application code itself. So let's first think about how a web application works. Three ingredients of a web application is HTML, for how a web app should look like, CSS, for styling the web app, and JavaScript for interactions. And how these three ingredients work together is that when you open a web app on the browser, it loads the HTML first. And in the HTML, there will be a link tag to specify where the CSS file will be, as well as a script tag to indicate the JavaScript file. So the browser will load them and evaluate them accordingly. So if your web app is simple enough, one HTML file, one CSS file and one JavaScript file is there it is. Is that straightforward? But oftentimes, building a web app isn't that straightforward. For better code organization, sometimes you have multiple JavaScript files. For having a tool to make sense of the type of for your variables, you may want to use TypeScript. And for a more powerful tool to write CSS, you may want to use Sass as a CSS preprocessor. The browser does not understand TypeScript nor Sass, so you'll need to build them into JavaScript and CSS. And with more and more code, loading all of them at once makes things slower and slower. So you may want to figure a way to group code into groups, which you can load them only when you need to use them. And also compress and minify your code by renaming variables into something shorter, removing comments and unnecessary spaces. Could be a good idea, right? As that would mean less code needed to be downloaded to the browser, so a faster website. If your code includes syntaxes or web APIs that is not widely supported by all the browsers that you want to support, then you may need to add an extra step to transform your code into something that can be run by all the browsers you want to support. Do all the things that I've mentioned so far, and probably more, you'll need a build process. Roughly about 10 years ago, you probably will have to set up pipelines and workflows to transform, optimize, and concatenate all of the codes or assets you have to build a web applications. However, in recent years, building a web app, you use a new class of tools, which we usually call them the module bundlers, in which they look at the project as a whole and build your web application for you, somewhat automatically. Instead of combining all the codes you write into one JavaScript files, module bundlers analyzes the code you write, finds out the code that is in use, and transform them, bundle them together. It allows you to lazily load your code conditionally and intelligently splits the code into smaller files so that the browser can load them in parallel. And we're going to look at each of and every step in detail and how it's being done by different tools in this series. You've seen the logos that I showed up so far. We're going to talk about each of the tools. So stay tuned. I know it's a rather short one because it's more of an introduction to the new series. So please write in the comment section on what you'd like to learn about building web application. Could be a particular scenario or use case or particular tools. Please write them and I'll try my best to cover them. So, until then, bye!